Whether you're sending your document to a print shop or printing right at home, Swift Publisher has all you need. Before taking our work to the print shop, we need to export it to a graphic file and set up a few options. To get to the Export dialog, click File in the menu bar, and then Export. Here, we need to type in a file name and select a destination. In the Format menu, we can see that Swift Publisher can export to PDF, TIFF, JPEG, PNG, and EPS. Let's choose PDF, and then check out the available options. The first option is Bleeds. Note that we always need to check with our print shop before setting them up, as requirements may differ. We can also opt to include cut marks. Then, we can set up the image quality. The original option tells the program to leave all the images as they are. Contrary, the next three options can decrease the image resolution if it is higher than the selected value. By setting lower resolution, you can make the created PDF smaller, which is convenient for online publication or emailing it. All options here, except for original, convert images to the RGB color palette. Let's go for the original image quality. In the next drop-down list, we have a choice of quartz filters, which basically apply some graphic effect to all images in the PDF. You may find useful the reduce file size filter. As long as we want to have original images, we select none. The following option, convert text to curves, basically makes sure that your font displays on other computers correctly. It's a good idea to use this option when your document contains fonts that are not installed on your system by default. Some print shops prefer to receive PDFs with texts converted to curves, so make sure you check their requirements. Just remember that text converted to curves increases the size of PDF files. If your document contains multiple pages, you can choose to export all of them or only some particular pages. Next, we can format our project as a booklet. We'll get to that more in depth when we talk about printing. You can define what the program should do with your PDF when it has been created. For example, if you need to send it by email, just select Mail PDF. A new email with your PDF as an attachment will be created automatically. For now, let's leave that at none. Click OK and save our PDF. Print shops also work with raster file formats such as TIFF. Settings for this format let you activate bleeds and choose the resolution. But what is more important, you can select the CMYK color model, which is frequently required by commercial printers. Now, let's take a look at printing. To get started, we need to click the Print button in the program toolbar. The dialog that comes up is quite standard. We have options to the right and a preview to the left. We can choose a printer, a preset such as default settings, and the settings last used. Change the number of copies. Select which pages to print. And choose a different paper size. Now, the program has its own set of options that are located below. The quantity and merge printing settings are used together with dynamic fields. Since we don't have any, let's just skip those. The following is scale to fit to paper size. This comes in handy when you've created a document that is larger than the paper you're printing to. Next, we have Format as Booklet. This option automatically arranges your pages so that when printed out and folded, they are in the correct order. So that's basically a wrap for both export and printing in Swift Publisher. So let's go ahead and click Print to get our results.